Security cameras record the moment a basement in a home starts to fill up with rainwater. And then water pressure from Hurricane Ida is too much to bear, and the walls give in. The family was able to escape. They were lucky. In New York City, many were not. 13 people were killed after being trapped inside basement apartments. They ranged in age from an 86-year-old woman to a 2-year-old boy and both his parents, all found dead in flooded basement apartments they were unable to escape. Housing experts say up to 300,000 illegal basement dwellings in New York City may not conform to safety codes and don't have proper drainage or escape routes. Many of the people who live in them are on low incomes and often immigrants who can't afford to live anywhere else. The city doesn't have exact numbers of illegal basement dwellings, but the governor said floods are the new normal, so they need to find answers.
With the higher elevations now, where the flash floods, which were unknown before, this is the first time we've had a flash flood event of this proportion in the city of New York and in the outlying areas. We haven't experienced this before, but we should expect it the next time.
In Louisiana, recovery efforts are hampered by power outages and continued flooding. Residents of a senior living community were evacuated after living without power for several days. The staff had all evacuated days before, leaving residents alone and in the dark.
No, nobody showed up. Nobody, not one person showed up to come check on us.
All 8 electricity transmission lines feeding southwest Louisiana were knocked offline by Ida. Officials say power won't be completely restored to many areas until the middle of this week, and the hardest hit areas until September 29th. It's clear after Hurricane Ida, something needs to be done. And President Joe Biden is looking towards Congress to take more action on his multi-trillion-dollar infrastructure plan that he says will make the U.S. better prepared for extreme weather and climate change. Biden is planning to tour the hardest hit areas in New Jersey and New York on Tuesday. Gabriel Elizondo, Al Jazeera, Washington.